our advocate in heaven, to bring us to eternal life. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with all.
Almighty God, our heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Shoes for your feet, put on whatever will make you ready.
keep alert, and always persevere in supplication for all the saints. Pray also for me, so that when I speak, a message may be given to me to make known with boldness the mystery of the gospel, for which I am ambassador in chains. Pray that I may declare it boldly, as I must speak. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our gradual hymn is number 658. Help us, O Lord, to learn.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the crowd, "Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood abide in me, and I in them. Just as the living Father sent me, and I live because of the Father, so whoever eats me will live because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven, not like that which your ancestors ate and they died, but the one who eats this bread will live forever." He said these things while he was teaching in the synagogue in Capernaum. When many of his disciples heard it, they said, "This teaching is difficult to accept. Who can accept it?" But Jesus, being aware that his disciples were complaining about it, said to them, "Does this offend you? They wanted you to see the Son of Man ascending to where he was before. The Spirit that gives life, the flesh is useless. The words that I have spoken to you are Spirit and life. But among you there are some who do not believe. But Jesus knew from the first who were the ones that did not believe, and who was the one that would betray him. And he said, 'For this reason I have told you that no one can come to me unless it is granted by the Father.' Because of this, many of his disciples turned back and no longer went about with him. So Jesus asked the 12, 'Do you also wish to go away?' Simon Peter answered him, 'Lord, to whom can we go? You have the words of eternal life. We've come to believe and know that you are the Holy One of God.' This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Father, and the Son, stories, these found fantastic stories during the research of our Second World War project. Stories for ordinary people, one of which appears to imply a bigamous marriage of someone named Davis, I think. All very happy, it seems. And along with kind of humorous stories, poignant stories too, of people who, one of whom had an escape from a situation which would have led really to her death, had she circumstances been different. And these stories echo with us because they kind of touch a nerve within us, because we empathise with the people who were there. Well, I heard a podcast recently about the way in which we won the Battle of Britain, partly by the bravery and the self-sacrifice of ordinary people at the time, but also because this is sometimes not really appreciated. The country was so well organised. It was actually extremely organised, so that if news got through of German planes coming across, the RAF just scrambled planes off the airfields, so that if they came with these bombers and fighters came across, bombed the airfields, that's all they did. They just bombed a field because the planes had gone. They knew about this because there was a system of people looking out, literally watching the sky for planes coming across. And if a squadron of German planes came across, they just simply got on the phone and said, "Oh, these planes are coming out now." And they went. So the damage was limited. Also because there was a fantastic system of radar around, especially the whole country really, but especially around the southeast. So the Germans started off the war with, it's thought, vastly more planes than the RAF. It wasn't actually all that much, but they did start off with more. The RAF quickly caught up. But the thing is about these planes, they couldn't all be here at the same time. And once they were here, they couldn't stay here very long because they'd run out of fuel, so they had to go back to France where they came from. So it wasn't quite as bad as people at the time thought in the general population. But there was this system of radar, so that as well as these people watching for the planes, as soon as any planes entered our airspace, it was known about. So off all the planes went, off all the airfields, and the damage was limited. If and it was a field, so if the runway was bombed, okay, it wasn't the end of the world, because by the next day, it could quickly be repaired, the soil was just filled in. So we were never as badly off as people generally assumed at the time. And top military historian that I've been reading about, James Holland, said, we were never going to lose. It was always going to be all right. And the best thing was this radar system. And the radar system was a series of radar stations, lots of them, literally hundreds of them, all over the country, and say, particularly in the southeast. Germans never actually realised the power of this radar. They kind of hit some radar stations, but they didn't go out of the way to target them. If they had done, things could have possibly got a lot worse. But if one was hit, if a radar station was hit, and those of you who remember, this is important information to me, if a radar station was hit, it didn't matter. Because the knowledge that was being transmitted went all around it. Like, imagine a picture, imagine a kind of net. So if one of the knots in that net was hit and it went out, it didn't matter. All of the information just went around it and it was quickly repaired. One thing was missing from the radar station. It didn't matter because all of this information just went around it. I've met in the course of my ministry many people who feel if we have one thing missing in our lives, and I've never met any one person yet who's got like 100% right, who's got everything right in their life, if one thing is missing, the love of God is stronger than that. It just simply goes round it. It just simply, like a network, goes round it and can enfold us and feed us, literally, as it says in that Bible reading, feed us. And it doesn't matter, because God's love is stronger. God's love is stronger than our perception of it. We might think that something is missing in our lives, but God's love is stronger than that. It doesn't matter. It can just go round it and enfold us in its power and in its love, so that we can have that life, that true quality of life that Jesus was talking about in our reading. One thing that I know has helped a lot of people is, if you might have known that there's a poem called Footsteps, where someone's, it says a map, it could apply it to anybody, is walking along the seashore, and he's looking back on his life, and he's kind of thinks that he's walking with God, but he notices that in the very most difficult, the very worst times of his life, there's only one step of footprints. There's only one step of footprints. And he wonders at those times why he thinks God has abandoned him, why he's only him walking along. And he says to God, why in those times did you leave me? Why did you leave me to just walk along? And God says to him, my precious, precious child, I didn't leave you. In those difficult, dark, and desolate times, it was me that was carrying you. If there's only one set of footprints, it's because they're mine. I was carrying you at that time. Well, I thought of that, thinking about the stories of the war and the radar and Stephen's stories and all the rest, because in our recent holiday to France, we had the opportunity to see some of these places where dreadful things, but hugely important things took place. So we went to Pegasus Bridge, that fantastic story, the bridge that was held against all the odds. And we went to the beaches where literally thousands of people died on that first day of D-Day over our beach. And we looked out and we saw the sea where these people came in. And the thing is, when you're on a shore, when you're on a shoreline, you can look out to sea and you think you're looking out into the vastness of the horizon, but you actually only can see 24 miles. So that's the extent of the horizon you can see. You can only see 24 miles out. That's where the curvature of the earth stops you seeing beyond. But the sea is vastly bigger than that. That was 24 miles. One of the things that one of my daily rituals is to play internet games with my children. And we play these games, Wordle, where you have to kind of guess a word. A state up, you have to press, you can kind of guess as the, you have to choose which state it is just simply by the outline of the state. How many here could tell you if you just saw the silhouette, the outskirt, the outline lines of Michigan, could you get that? I could get it straight away because it's 2 second pieces. Congratulations, so long. And Wordle, if that's another one. You get the silhouette of a country. You get the silhouette of a country. Who here could get, just by the silhouette, the Solomon Islands, or Benin, or Ghana? Actually, I could, because I've played it so long, you see, I recognise these shapes. But one of the things it does, if you guess it wrong, it tells you how far away from the, it tells you how far away you are from the country. So, it's surprising just how big the distances are. So, from this country to the Falkland Islands, anybody know how many miles that is?
6,000.
Any guesses?
6,000.
Oh, that's a good guess, actually. It's It's actually 8,000. Really, very close. Well done. 6,000. So if you get something that appears to say China, that's about the outskirts of China. That's about 14,000. If you get something right to the other side of the world, that's 26,000 miles away. So you're on a shore and you're looking out and you think you're seeing a vast distance. You're seeing 24 miles. If you go to the other side of the world, it's 24,000 miles. How vast is that? How bigger is that than any horizon we can see? Not to say the depth of the ocean, that huge space. So what we can see is only a tiny fragment of what's real. That's the same what God offers to us. That's the same as God's offer to us of that bread of eternal life. God wants to give us that life and give us that life in its fullness. And sometimes there are things in our lives that will stop us from accepting that life. It doesn't matter, because God's love is such vastly bigger than that. It enfolds us, it encapsulates us, it wraps itself around us. In my induction service here, one of the hymns I chose was, "Here is love vast as the ocean." Is it love vast as the ocean? And just how big that is too big really for us to imagine. But that's what God offers to us, life, and life in all its fullness. And no matter what we think might be lacking in our lives, that power of God's love is stronger than that to feed us, to enable us to live life to its fullness, to give us strength, and to give us that sustenance, and above all, that love. Amen. And so let's start with the third part in the Word of our faith. Let us declare our faith in God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We believe in one God, Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten and not made, of the one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified and was crucified. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son it is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We are called for baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray.
To our Lord in prayer and supplication, knowing that he who suffered persecution and death to show us the extent of his love hears our prayers and will be with us in all our joys and sorrows. Lord of the Church, help the Church to put on the whole Christian armour. Help us hold to the shield of faith when evil and hatred seem to flourish. May we witness to the world of the world, we pray for all troubled places. Nations divided by terrorism, envy and hatred. Places suffering the effects of storm or drought. Bless all those who work to bring relief to all those who have lost families, homes or livelihoods. We pray for all who seek to bring unity and harmony to our world, that they may be guided by your Spirit. We pray for those whose decisions affect the economies of the world and the daily lives of your children. Help governments, communities and individuals to bring justice in place of oppression, willingness to share in place of selfishness, and contentment with what we have in place of grasping or greed. Lord, in your mercy. Lord of our lives, we pray for the community in which you have placed us. We pray for young people who have had important examination results and face new challenges. Bless them as they make decisions about their futures and be with each one on the next step of their journeys. Bless our schools and colleges, both teachers and students, as they look forward to a new year and new discoveries. Help us to be the people you want us to be. May we not be conformed to this world, but strive to discern your will. Lord, in your mercy. Lord of wholeness and healing, we pray for all whose lives are broken by drink and drugs and find it hard to change. We pray for all who are trapped by abusive relationships or by poverty. Build up the broken, the hopeless, the sick. We ask for your blessing and comfort for all who mourn, and for all we know who are in distress of any kind, for the sick and the housebound, the disappointed and the disaffected. Lord, in your mercy. Lord of the risen life, we give thanks for all who have changed from glory to glory, who have left behind the restrictions of this life, and walk now before you as children of God. We commend to you all our loved ones and friends who have departed this life, remembering today David Wade. May he now rejoice in the music of heaven. And we pray that we, with your whole church in heaven and on earth, may feast together at your table. Lord, in your mercy. As those who seek to live as children of God, we offer these prayers in the name of Christ. Merciful Father,
accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
You please stand. Our Saviour Christ, Prince of Peace, of the increase of his peace and his government, there shall be no end. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace. Thank you. Wise and gracious God, you spread a table before us. Nourish your people with the word of life and with the bread of heaven. Amen. The Lord is here.
He is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Father, we give you thanks and praise through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your living word, through whom you have created all things, who was sent by you in your great goodness to be our Saviour. By the power of the Holy Spirit he took flesh, and as your Son, born of the Blessed Virgin, he lived on earth and went about among us. He opened wide his arms for us on the cross. He put an end to death by dying for us, and revealed the resurrection by rising to new life. So he fulfilled your will, and won for you a holy people. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious day, forever praising you and singing. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin." Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Great is the mystery of faith. Rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we in the company of Michael and Mark and of all the saints may praise and glorify you forever through Jesus Christ our Lord. By whom, and with whom, and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever. He broke his bread to share in the body of Christ.
The Lord and me,
we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Feed on him in your heart by faith and with thanksgiving. Amen. God, our Creator, you feed your children with the true manna, the living bread of heaven. Let this holy food sustain us through our earthly pilgrimage until we come to that place where hunger and thirst are no more, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Father of all, we give you thanks and praise. When we were still far off, you met us in your Son and brought us home. Dying and living, you pledged your love, gave us grace, and opened the gates of glory. May we, who share Christ's body, live his life. We who drink his cup, bring life to others. We who the Spirit lights, give life to the world. Give you a firm and the hope you have set before us, so we and all your children shall be free, and the whole earth live to praise your name, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Just a couple of notices from me this morning. As I mentioned last week, please do keep free the evening before Remembrance Sunday. Continuing our Second World War theme, we're going to have a 1940s night, the night before Remembrance Sunday. So we're going to have a kind of a full dance band, Glenn Miller style band here on the stage, with singer and tables around and dancing 1940s style in the church. It's going to be a fantastic evening. Time, not necessarily to raise money, but just as a time of fellowship at our church, and just to enjoy that brilliant music from that time. So that's 1940s night, the evening before Remembrance Sunday. We just set up, re-established, I should say, something that happened some time ago in the church, which is the prayer chain. So there's a group of people who volunteered to be people who pray regularly during the week for intentions, for intercession that anybody would like to be prayed for. If you'd like to be part of the prayer chain, that's brilliant. Please have a word with me. If you'd like anybody or anything included on the prayer chain, again, please have a word with me at any time. It's going to be pieces of paper at the back of church to write intentions on. So if you'd like someone to be prayed for, or someone, or some need, please write them in. They need to be given to me so that I can communicate them to the rest of the prayer chain. Please do complete those. But for now, if you can just have a word with me or text or email, and I'll make sure any prayers that are asked for are given to our prayer chain to be prayed for. Also, at our PCC arrangement last week, we're going to set up a fabric committee to look after this beautiful church. So it's not just all for one or two people. So if you'd like to be part of the fabric committee, you don't have to have any special building skills, because I certainly don't have any. But if you'd like to be part of that, please do speak to me after the service or at any time during the week. That's re-establishing a fabric committee. Please do have a word with me. I think that's all I'm going to do.
It was cupboard love here yesterday, and there are rather a lot of runner beans in a box at the back there. So if you want to take some, please do. And if you could consider leaving a donation, that would be even more brilliant. Thank you.
Thank you.
Our final thing this morning from 755, it's 755.
Thank you.
blessing of God Almighty.